killed. Dead.
The child is dead, Excellency.
It's extraordinary to me that you people cannot take care of yourselves and your children. One or the other of you is forever in the way. How do you know what injury might do to my horses? Drive on, faster. Irritating episode.
The Marquis drives fast.
We'll drive him fast to his tomb.
My dear nephew, what goes forward here?
I'm leaving. I'm going to England.
Really? Monsieur Gabel, when you were my nephew's tutor, you shouldn't have encouraged him to be so petulant.
You have made the name of Evrémonde the most detested in all France. I can't endure your cruelty to the peasants.
There is a sickness these days which labels itself humanitarianism.
You have no pity for those who suffer.
Pity, my dear boy, is a diseased variety of sentimentality. Do you pity the swine whose flesh we eat?
The peasants are not swine.
That, my dear Charles, is where you and I differ. I'm very much afraid, my good tutor, that you have taught my nephew to take the new philosophy of equality seriously. Now, I enjoy Monsieur Voltaire and these other modern philosophers, but I take them lightly, merely as an exercise for the mind.
Most of our lands are stolen. I intend to see them returned to the peasants to whom they rightfully belong.
Really? You may thank your stars that you're related to me, Charles, or you might very well find yourself in the Bastille.
Monseigneur, I pray you overlook the impulsiveness of youth.
My dear uncle, I'm not frightened of anything you can do.
Charles, I beg of you.
I'm not at all sure that it wouldn't be the patriotic thing to imprison you, Charles, in spite of the pain it would cause me personally. By the by, if you should run into any difficulties in England, let me know. The prisons, even in that utopia, are very uncomfortable, they tell me.